Dear students, today I am going to discuss on the topic Vernacular Press Act of 1878, provisions, repercussions and reasons. Now let's discuss the topic in detail. The Vernacular Press Act in India under the British government was enacted in 1878. The act was proposed by Lord Lytton, then Viceroy of India, and was unanimously passed by the Viceroy's Council on 14th March 1878. The Act was basically enacted to curtail the freedom of the Indian language press and prevent the expression of criticism towards British policies in the vernacular languages. The Act was to establish a check over the vernacular language press in India. The Act states that it is for, quote, the better control of the publications in Oriental languages, unquote. It was to control seditious writing in the vernacular newspapers everywhere in the country except the South. The British government also stated that too much was being written in these newspapers of the injustice and tyranny of the British government. The main object of the Act was to place newspapers published in the Indian languages under better control and to furnish the government with more effective means than the existing law provided. It is also to discourage the seditious writings against the government, which the government considered that the newspapers were producing disaffection towards the government in the minds of the ignorant Indian population. The main objects of the Act was to place newspapers published in the Indian languages under better control and to furnish the government with more effective means than the existing law provided. It is also to discourage the seditious writings against the government, which the government considered that the newspaper were producing disaffection towards the government in the minds of the ignorant Indian population. It was also meant to punish those involving in unscrupulous writings and using their newspapers as a means of intimidation and extortion. The main point of controversy was the discrimination made between the disloyal native and the loyal British, as the Act was only for the vernacular language newspapers but not for the English language publications. Reasons leading to the enactment of the Act. First one, growing language press. By the 1870s, the press in Indian languages were growing rapidly. There were about 62 Indian languages newspapers in Bombay, about 60 in the northwest provinces, south and the central provinces, some 28 in Bengal, about 19 in Madras, in Tamil, Telugu and Malayalam and Hindustani languages. There were probably 1 lakh readers of such newspapers, and the highest circulation of any one newspaper was about 3,000. Number 2. Criticisms to government policies by vernacular press. The Indian language press has been causing concern and uneasiness to the government for many years since its inception. They were highly vocal against the policies of the British government in India. The most recent impetus was given by the criticisms by the vernacular press on the issues of opium cultivators in abundance. Earlier, they had also acquired a mild reputation as having disseminated seditious thought through symbols and apparently innocent words before the Great Rebellion. Lack of understanding of local languages. Since India has a multiplicity of languages, the vernacular publications were published in numerous languages from different corners of the country. The diverse vernacular publications made it difficult for the English government to understand the contents of the said newspapers. Consequently, the government had to depend on Indians to be acquainted with what was published on them. The contents of the vernacular press has been very critical without the knowledge of the government, as it was evident from the 1859 report of Reverend Long, who had said that if the newspapers of the northwest provinces had been studied carefully in 1856 to 57, the Great Rebellion could have been foreseen. The Indian language press was kept under careful scrutiny, and when Lord Lytton became the Viceroy in 1876, he had a pile up formidable documents on the transgressions of Indian language press. People and newspapers responsible for the enactment of vernacular press. First is Neel Darpan, published in 1861. It was a Bengali drama on indigo cultivation written by Dinabandhu Mitra. Indigo cultivation had been the subject of a long controversy in the press. It was stated that the cultivation of indigo was not voluntary on the part of the Indian peasants, that the peasants were submerged in indebtedness and oppression in many ways. As a result, farmers revolted against the planters. The depiction of the situation of indigo farmers was made in Neel Darpan, which consequently created a huge controversy. Neel Darpan was banned by the East India Company. Som Prakash, published in 15 November 1858, started by Vidyasagar under the editorship of Dwaranath Vidyabhushan. Som Prakash was the first Bengali newspaper to engage in political discussions. It did not support all policies of the government and raised the voice against the Vernacular Press Act. It was known as an ably conducted weekly newspaper which gave much useful information and made its contribution to the indigo controversy. After the Vernacular Press Act, Som Prakash aroused the ire of the government and publication was suspended for a year. After providing written assurance of allegiance to the government, it reappeared on 19th April 1880. Another newspaper was Amrita Bazar Patrika, started in March 1868. It was started as a Bengali weekly by Shishir Kumar Ghosh and his brothers from the village of Amrit Bazar in Jaisal district. In 1869, the Amrita Bazar Patrika started publishing columns in English, and in 1871, the newspaper was moved reluctantly to Calcutta. After a pause, it started publishing as a bilingual weekly from Calcutta in February 1872. This newspaper too contributed several articles on the controversy of indigo cultivation. Another newspaper was Bengali, started in 1868, founded by Girish Chandra Ghosh, fearlessly expounded its views on public questions. The newspaper, which lacked financial stability, was taken over by Bacharam Chatterjee, who could not sustain it, and then was purchased by Surendranath Banerjee. Sulabh Samachar, started in 1870, was started by Keshav Chandra Sen, preacher of Brahmo Samaj, started it as the organ of the Indian Reform Association. It was published weekly at 1 paise per issue and was therefore the first attempt to reach those who were poor but literate. Its circulation of 3,000 to 4,000 as a weekly was remarkable for the time. Halisara Patrika. Jankinath Gangopadhyay started it in 1871. It was initially published with the intention to teach the people high moral values, but when it converted into weekly from a monthly publication, the topics of politics and social issues were also included. Bharat Mihir. The newspaper was published from Memensing, now in Bangladesh, but it had a branch in Calcutta. This newspaper was banned in 1878 under the provisions of the Vernacular Press Act. Apart from all these above mentioned newspapers, there are many other vernacular newspapers such as Deccan Prakash, Sadarini, Bharat Sansharak, etc. that had contributed to the criticisms of government policies on various occasions prior to the Vernacular Press Act. Apart from the indigo cultivation, which directly and indirectly led the British government in India to consider enacting the Vernacular Press Act in 1878. Now, provisions of the Act. Number A. The Act provided for submitting to police all the proof sheets of contents of pre-censorship before publications. B. What was seditious news was to be determined by the police and not by the judiciary. C. Any magistrate or commissioner of police had the authority to call upon any printer or publisher of a newspaper to enter into a bond undertaking not to print a certain kind of material it deemed objectionable, to demand security and confiscate it if it was thought fit, and confiscate any printed matter deemed objectionable. D. The affected party could not seek redress in a court of law. No recourse to a court of law was open to such a printer or publisher. The vernacular press would be punished if the following were published: A. Subversion of democratic institutions. B. Agitations and violent incidents. C. False allegations against British authorities or individuals. D. Endangering law and order to disturb the normal functioning of the state. And E. Threats to internal stability. The provisions of the Vernacular Press Act of 1878 had given utmost impunity to law enforcing agency to act immediately against the transgressors. Their impunity was nowhere to be questioned, not even a judiciary, as the affected party had no right to seek redress in the court of law. This act was absolutely inhuman and one of the most controversial acts under British India. Since the press censorship was imposed, the contents of the newspaper were strictly limited for publication. Nothing concerning the political activities were to be allowed to publish on them, let alone the government policies. Now, what were the repercussions of the act? Several vernacular newspapers and their proprietors, publishers, editors, and people associated with them suffered after the enactment of this act. Many vernacular language newspapers were fined, their editors confined, and the printing equipments were seized. The act came into severe criticism. All the prominent leaders of India condemned the act as unwarranted and unjustified and demanded its immediate withdrawal. The act provoked fierce criticism throughout India. However, the changes in the writing of the vernacular press were witnessed post its enactment. C.B. Buckland, who had temporarily appointed as press commissioner under the Vernacular Press Act, had written that the next year in 1880, despite the opposition to the government and its measures, the improvement in the style and languages of the vernacular press were seen after the implementation of Vernacular Press Act. They have also been found to follow the English press, and new features in their columns where the utmost attention was given to English politics. Finally, in 1880, when the Liberals came to power in Britain, and Gladstone, who had denounced the Vernacular Press Act, became Prime Minister, the successor of Lord Lytton was instructed to repeal the Act. In 1881, Lord Ripon, the new Viceroy, carried out the repeal, though postal authorities were allowed to retain the power to search for and seize any publications of seditious nature.